This is Patrick. Can you hear me? Hello, can you? Yeah, hi. You can ask them to turn the volume up a bit. I'm not quite hearing it.
Thanks.
No, I need the MCR. I can't hear them. It's very faint. Yes, I think so. You don't know. Have you reconnected Mike on the duplex? Have you reconnected Mike on the duplex because his cross country is being cancelled?
Thank you.
Mike, are you there?
Geography, yep. Yep.
Ah, good. Blimey, it's like trying to communicate with a dead stone. Are you? What's the score? Are you in for the whole race?
I am.
Good. Okay. Can you hear the MCR in Paris, Mike?
Yes, I can.
Good.
Sorry, Paddy, I thought we were live there. It's a buzz. Don't know what's happening today.
It's all right. Well, a very good morning. Welcome back to Oestersund. It's been a chilly night, snowing in Scotland, minus 11 here in Oestersund, minus 21, 22 in Finland. Not the sort of conditions that the athletes are used to racing in at this time of the year. So it's caused a few delays in Finland. The cross country at the moment is going to be shown at or raced at 12:45 UK time, and that will be on Discovery Plus. The biathlon is okay. Minus 11 is legal. We will get this race underway, and we're going to start with the women's sprint event. 7.5 kilometers first sprint of the season. And after yesterday, Mike, where is your money? Is it going on Markita Davidova, who had a fabulous race yesterday?
Oh, she really did. I'm not sure today that Davidova, that she has the ski speed, but certainly when you look at the Uber sisters who live here, train here, this is their base. They didn't shoot well yesterday, but they set, two of the best ski times, first and third. So I think Sweden may be back in the race again today.
Yeah, we'll cast your eye down the start sheet. Again, a lot of the favourites going in Group 1. We've come to expect that. It does make it a bit of a marathon session to stick it all the way through to number 116, because you pretty much know that the race is over after the first 35, 40 minutes. It's a contentious point. We won't argue it out today. What I will say, Mike, the Swedes, the top four Swedes yesterday, missed 25% of their targets. The Norwegians had a bad day and they only missed 15%.
it's extraordinary. We don't often see the home team underperform as much as we did yesterday in terms of the Swedish men and women, actually. And I don't know what the score was there. I think their ski speeds have improved so much. Their expectations were to win. And with that came a little bit of tension, a little bit of extra pressure.
Amanda Lightfoot going number 67, didn't start yesterday, doesn't start again today, it seems. So must be health issue. Haven't actually heard from the British camp, but I'm assuming there's a cold or something. You have to be fairly careful at this time of year.
Yes, these temperatures, when you're sucking the volumes of air, even at minus 11 here, it can do some harm if you're just coming on the back or off the back of a cold.
Yeah, I was out for a very slow jog last night and someone was moaning because it was 1 degree, not minus one, it was 1 degree. They were moaning it was too cold. Minus 17, 18, that was pretty tough for the cross-country skiers yesterday in Ruka. Let's hope it gets a few degrees. It's due to get warm up to minus 18. Ridiculous thing to say, but it is due to get to about minus 18 at midday, which is why they've rescheduled the women's race up there. I do hope that gets underway, Mike, because it's going to be a fascinating encounter with Frida Carlsen Andersen and of course Therese Johaug all bidding to be the queen of cross country this season.
Yes, these early season races exciting. We saw that yesterday in both biathlon races. And another big surprise in the men's field here yesterday, Johannes Tingis Bo, somewhat 1 minute 3 seconds slower than the fastest ski time. It's unusual.
Unusual, unheard of almost, but his form comes pretty quickly. I wonder whether he's got a different tactic for this year. There's Lisa Theresa Hauser. She's become one of the mainstays in the women's tour, and she's got an early start. Goes off number three. It's a powerful start list, isn't it, Mike? Brésard Boucher, Emma Lunda, who had an outstanding performance yesterday, getting a PB for Canada. Then Hauser, then Marie Ada, the veteran from Finland, and Dorothea Vera starting number five.
I think the athlete who felt best about the start sheet last night, Patrick, would have been Marta Oshbu-Reuschland. 38th start today from the first group, had 40 of the best athletes in it. So she's got a real commanding view over all of those ahead of her. And I thought she looked excellent yesterday, although the ski time was a little off the best pace.
But that doesn't quite tie in with what you said yesterday, is you've got to you've absolutely not got to think about the situation when you come into the range. So in biathlon, starting after the favourites isn't really a help until you've completed your last shoot.
I think in terms of the final push, so if you have to try and pull back 6 seconds over the last 2.5, Reuschland's your athlete who I think can achieve that today. She's got all the times ahead of her.
Well, if you've just joined us, a very warm welcome to Oestersund. This is the first venue of the year, as it has been on many occasions. We've got 2 weeks here in central Sweden, and that cuts down the travelling for the athletes. We had an individual yesterday. Women racing over 15k today. They cut that distance in half. It's a 7.5 kilometer sprint, penalty loops instead of penalty time for missed targets. And Justine Brésard Boucher, 25-year-old Frenchwoman, will be the first to try out the course today. What was she, 58th here last year at the end of last season, missing two in both the prone and the stand. She's got to do better than that, but she had real problems in the prone yesterday, hitting just 50%. Emma Lunda, Mike, what a brilliant start to her season.
What a sensation, control throughout. She really has improved her ski speed, and you know what, Emma Lunda must be expecting many, many more top tens, top fives, and I think podiums as the season goes on.
Yeah, she was 26th in the World Cup rankings last year. And she said the most exciting thing about that was the fact that it put her into the mass starts on many occasions. And she raced in the mass start at the World Championships, her highlight of the year. Now, Lisa Theresa Hauser comes from just outside Kitzbühel, a town called Reith, 27 now. Her form really over the last 2-3 seasons has been going stratospheric. Absolutely brilliant race yesterday, 0-0-0-1 to finish in second place behind, of course, Davidova of the Czech Republic.
And you know, I think, Patrick, so much of that change is handed to a coach that understands in-depth biathlon, can really get inside the head of athletes. It really makes a difference, and he really has turned Hauser's performances round.
Yeah, her confidence really is sky high. Mary Ada, very experienced, hasn't had a podium since 2017. She's 34 now. I suspect she's on that list of athletes who will probably call it a day at the end of the Olympic Games this time around.
Yes, Susan Dunkley, she starts 100 today. She's one of those who is definitely retiring after this season.
Vera. Let's hope she doesn't go. She's been a breath of fresh air on the women's tour over the last four seasons. Always good for an interview. Yeah, she's got plenty to say. Let's put it like that.
Well, Todorova getting underway. She had a good season last year and eighth here, in fact, at the end of March. And that's got to be a positive feeling with a perfect 0-0. And when you've had some success at a venue, it carries. It can certainly carry through to the next season. You clearly like what you do on these tracks and suitable for your technique and conditions. 3:01 for Brisa Boucher. And I think that's a good time. Maybe not be the fastest at the end of the day to this point, but certainly a powerful start. Descending down now. Deceptive little drop-off that is as you spin to the left.
The first eight underway in the women's sprint. That's a fairly dynamic start from Anaïs Chevalier-Boucher. This is her event. She got a brilliant silver medal in the World Championships in Pokljuka last year, hitting 0-1. You know, she wasn't far off the pace set by Tyrylekhov, to be honest, the eventual gold medal winner. Hauser always looks as though she's traveling slowly, but she's a giant of a woman, very, very powerful. Skate two up the majority of the steep climb. There's been a fair bit of weight training going on over the summer months.
There has. I love that camera shot from the side. It just shows how steep that little kicker, the steepest part of this long and steep, about 17% there on the steepest section. And then you get the recovery back to the range.
Franziska Preutz next to go for Germany. Germany didn't have too much to sing and dance about, apart from Denise Herman's performance yesterday. And I guess, actually, Anna Vidal, who finished in ninth, that was a good run, hitting all 20 targets yesterday, one of only three athletes to achieve that.
I like the way that Ada is more dynamic this season, I feel, on her skis, and certainly her shooting. Sometimes she's edgy on the range. I thought she was quite calm. Didn't panic, even when there were a couple of shots missed yesterday. She just kept calm, and I feel good for her this season.
Now, what's Vera's split going to be? Outside that set by Marietta by some margin. That's interesting. Speed has never really been her forte. When she's on her best form, Mike, she can match. She's what, maybe half a percent, 1% below the fastest. But when she's not on her best form, she's some way slower than that. Lisa Vitozzi, brilliant recovery yesterday. Missed three on the very first shoot. She didn't miss another target after that.
That was quite incredible, wasn't it? And we often say if you're going to miss, miss early. And it's quite difficult to get the mindset when you've missed three out of five first time in. I thought she did a fantastic job to then hit the next 15.
Yeah, I was going to ask you, as we watch Avakumova racing now for Korea, I was going to ask you whether, if you're going to miss one in a sprint, would you rather miss it in the prone or in the stand?
I would absolutely go for miss early, and then you can do some pullback later, and you feel so much fresher leaving the range after the stand if you go straight out onto the track rather than that tight penalty loop of 150 meters.
Yeah, I absolutely take you, but the majority of women who won last year, missing one, missed it on the second shoot rather than the first one. I just found that slightly in contrast to the way we were thinking. Yesterday's winner just about to start. Top right corner of your screen. Davidova underway. Brésard Boucher, who started this race off, misses her first shot. So that's a penalty loop of 150 metres. And the race is only 7,500. So you can work out the percentages there.
Look at the shooting time there, 31.9. We will see today, without a doubt, some athletes taking total shooting time. That's from stopping skiing, taking your rifle off, magazines in, shoot off five till you start skiing again. We'll see some athletes at 22, 23 seconds. Quite a gain on the range. Lisa Teresa's time, Hauser there, bib three, only 11 seconds behind Brésard Boucher. I thought it might be more deficit.
Hannah Erberg, disappointing day yesterday. 74th position, 2-3-1-1. And it was Erberg who really got this the resurgence of the Swedish team going with her victory in Pyeongchang almost 4 years ago. I think we will see... I have no doubt we'll see better from her as this season goes on. 4 out of 5 for Hauser.
Well, Hauser was one of those fast shooters, 11 seconds to the first shot. She did hesitate after she missed. She needed to. You need to rebuild if you make a mistake. I think the first shot, Patrick, and the last shot are the two worst shots to miss. They unsettle you, or well, you can do nothing more about the last shot, but it affects your rhythm when you miss the first.
Yeah, I'm surprised to see Ada miss two. Elvira Erberg, 1 minute behind her sister. And I suspect that she will produce a quicker ski time than her sister. If she hits 10 out of 10, she is a potential winner, yet to win a World Cup, but she's looked very, very dangerous over the last, particularly last season. Vera, clear so far, but this is not a quick shoot by her standards, Mike. Six seconds, four seconds.
Look at the bolt, Patrick. She's having a real difficulty pushing that bolt all the way forward. It cost her 6 seconds. It's so unusual to see her taking 34 seconds. I'm amazed they haven't looked at that rifle after the issues it had yesterday.
Yeah, she called for help yesterday. Didn't need it in the end, but definitely was having issues. You thought there might have been a broken firing pin.
I did, and did you see her there? She's pushing it 80% forward, and then she has to really force it the final couple of millimeters, really off-putting, and it loosens your fix to the rifle in the shoulder, and that really affected her time on the range.
Do you think she cleans her own rifle, or do you think she has someone to do it for her?
I think she'll clean it. Most biathletes do, but any servicing a team, how luxurious is that to have an armorer?
So 5 out of 5 for Shvatova. That starts a good campaign for the Czech Republic, starting to come back to form after the early retirement of Kukalova.
Lovely to see Shvatova get all five there, because last year at 74% hit rate, it's a good start to the season.
That's a good shoot from Chevalier Boucher. And pretty quick as well. Now, how much of a lead is she going to have? Out she comes, still 10 seconds ahead. She passes the gun, or the wand, now 6.5. And France with the advantage. That's a really good start from them. Yesterday, the best of the French. Do we have to go all the way down to 28th with Anaïs Biscor? Surely not.
Well, as Preuss comes in there, interestingly, Chevalier Boucher and Brésard exactly same time into the range, and Chevalier Boucher taking 6 seconds from Brésard, her teammate, on the range.
Best shoot so far from Preuss, and they like that. They like that 4.6 outside coming in. I suspect she will have cut that deficit. It was pretty much 2 to 2.1 seconds in between each shot. And she has reduced the deficit to 2.9. She is in the mix. Elvira Urberg, well, we thought she'd go quick. She has gone super fast over the first climb.
Oh, she was so psyched up on the start line, just desperate to break free. She's really in fabulous form. And what a turnaround. The fastest ski time yesterday at Eckhoff, some 39 seconds behind in terms of ski time.
Now, Vitozzi missed three on her first shoot yesterday. Can't afford to miss any this time round.
Oh, incredibly fast to the first shot, and it's not very settling. You need to bed yourself down on that rifle so well. And yeah. That's expensive, so expensive early on.
Yeah, 14 given away before she came in to shoot. And another 300 metres of skiing, which is going to take her at least 40 seconds, probably more. There goes Tinel Eckhoff, and she sets out with a fair amount of intent. Gold medal in the World Championships in this event, a disappointing 30th yesterday with five misses in all. Davidova, who's settling on the firing point now, missed none. It was the perfect performance from Davidova. It was the performance we were expecting 12 months ago.
Yes, incredible. And of course, the reigning world champion in the individual. She hit all the targets back then in February in Pokljuka. Excellent.
So, five shoots completed, no targets missed so far. As Justine Brésard-Boucher comes in for her second shoot. That's good. That's good. That puts a little bit of pressure on those who've gone clear from the first round. And at the moment, we have six clear shoots from shoot number one, with Chevalier Boucher of France with the lead. Brésard Boucher is going to set the target time, 14.06.
Interestingly, I thought they were taking a lifetime to get her ski poles back on. The whole length of the range and almost up to the exit timing. Others will get their ski poles on a lot earlier, and it really does help you get some more momentum into your exit from the range.
Yeah, but she had thick gloves on, Mike, because of the temperatures, and that makes it very tricky indeed.
It is awkward, and you get these days you have to wear an inner pair, or as you say, a thicker pair, and it does change the feel, even through the rifle as well.
10 seconds ahead coming in for Urberg. I suspect it's going to be close to 20 seconds before the first round goes. 19.3.
I did put yesterday down to race nerves for the Swedish team. They wanted so much with their fast skiing.
Oh, just lost the concentration. She missed one in the first shoot yesterday. She's gone and done the same again today. But that 10 seconds that she gained on the first loop could come in handy. She joins Lisa Theresa Hauser on the penalty loop. And Brésard Boucher still with the leading time. Hauser has missed one. Vera clear in the prone.
She lost some now. 8 seconds in the prone in terms of time, and she's only 0.8 of a second behind Brésard Boucher.
Yeah, watch the recocking. That was okay. Missed a mass of targets yesterday in the stand, which is very unlike her.
My feeling is that she's having to throw that bolt forward far faster, more aggressively than normal, and it just, if you're not used to that bolt giving a problem, it changes things ever so slightly.
So she's not going to be more than 30 seconds off the lead, but it's not going to be Vera's day. Now, Lucy Shavatova. what she does on the range, Davidova seems to repeat.
Interesting hold through the hand hold there on the rifle. The wrist is very much bent. Normally, biathletes want to keep that wrist very straight, so all the weight is going straight into the rib, lower rib cage or the hip bone. Ah, what a pity. That hand hold, you can see how locked the wrist is. Perfection.
Chevalier Boucher, brilliant shooting. Good prone, good stand. And the French contingent of the crowd here in Oestersund enjoying that one, and so they should. That is a wonderful, wonderful performance. And remember, she did take the silver medal at the World Championship, so she could go one better today. It's early, early days, of course, but that is an impressive performance so far. 29 seconds to play with, and she's not skiing too badly either. Now, after Preutz, the next big name we're looking for is Hannah Erberg. I'm not sure we saw Hannah Erberg on her first shoot, Mike. She went clean, and she came out just 2 seconds down on Chevalier Boucher, who leads. So Hannah needs to hit five to stay in contention. Denise Herman, another podium finish yesterday. That's... first one we've seen change the sights.
Yes, very little in terms of wind movements today, but she decided I need to adjust it by 3 millimeters, the fall of the bullet. Seems to be skiing better today, Patrick Herrmann. She's only 12 seconds off the pace coming into the range.
Now, Roysland, almost the last of the athletes that has a real chance of winning here today. And Roysland certainly needs to be consistent this season if she wants to end up with the yellow bib. Norway zeroing on lane one, and hence Ekhoff has gone for lane one. Ski speed is good.
It's amazing that she's won the last 7 sprint events, not the World Championships, but at World Cup. Can she do it for the 8th time straight?
Not if she misses another one. She's still in it. She's still in it, but only just, Mike. The ski margins aren't quite what they were last year. 2.9 to play with, and so many people adjust their training in the Olympic year to focus on the games in the middle of February. Now, Justine Brézard, first to start, first to finish. That's always a nice feeling, but a miss early on, probably putting her out of contention for a top three. But that's not a bad time. 19:37 recorded. As you suggested, Mike, Davidova not with the ski speed to win this one.
Yes, it's almost too much, isn't it? Coming into the range, she's a deficit of 19.6 seconds. She's not going to win today.
Interesting that the two individual champions from the World Championships in Pokljuka last year ended up winning the race yesterday. Laigrid, of course, and Davidova. And if there's one event, Mike, where you see the same people winning, it is the individual.
Yes, and it brings. It was great to see Emma Lunda coming up, the Canadian, into sixth place. It allows, and Kobanaki, it allows outsiders to have an opportunity to get right into that top bracket.
Hannah Erberg, Mike, on the range. Big moment for her, big moment for the Swedes, clear in the prone. Can she make it five in the stand as well? She does, she's in the money. 2.6 outside coming in. She kept the margin between herself and Chevalier Boucher, and Hannah Erberg turns it around after a massively disappointing 74th position yesterday. I think a top three is likely. The question is, does she have the ski form to catch up with Chevalier Boucher? Well, she's done that on the range. That's a four-second turnaround on the range alone, and she could be heading for her first victory. We will have to wait and see. Hauser, 39 off the pace.
Oh, what a race. Amazing yesterday, Hannah Urberg missing seven from the 20 shots fired. And previously in that, in the individual, she was the master. She's got her shooting back again today, though.
Sandra Vold needs 10 out of 10 to feature in the top five, I suggest. Elvira Urberg missed in the prone, which has, I suspect, put her out of contention for the win. But a podium certainly possible with the ski speed she has. But there's another miss. 8 out of 10, and it will still be respectable. This one's important. Good recovery, little delay, but it was worth it. And she limits the damage to one penalty loop. Here comes Dorothea Vera, clear on the prone, but again missing on the stand. Hasn't had a clean stand so far this year, and goes into third, 42.7 behind. What do you think, Mike? 15th? Between, yeah, 10 and 15 with that?
I think so, and maybe even further down. And if you think back to the end of March, Vera took second in this race, last sprint of the season.
What's Chevalier Boucher coming in? This is big, 24 seconds inside. Brésard Boucher, France going 1 and 2. A really, really important performance for them, because, as I mentioned, the best of the French yesterday, all the way down in 28th position. Can Julia Simon join the party?
The shooting is not there. Jean-Paul taking the scores, marking where the shots missed. He'll think, what is going on? It should be better than only 3 hits out of 5 shots.
Yes, Simon with a poor day yesterday as well. Hettisch for Germany. Just looking at Germany's best scores. Preutz was up in fourth position after the first shoot.
Yes, Preutz is still out on the track. It's in third position at the moment at 7.1. That will change.
Hannah Urberg is on the way. Franziska Preutz coming in to finish. She should have Lotte Lee behind her, who's racing for Belgium. She's actually half Norwegian, half Belgium. Lotte Lee lives in Lillehammer. And she had a really good race yesterday, produced her PB. Third place at the moment for Preutz. She's gone ahead of Hauser. So, yeah, I think that's a sort of smile of satisfaction, Mike. Not her best, but she's getting there.
I think it is. And we've known for the last 10 years that she can control herself in the range. She's very good. But I'm so happy to see that her ski speed this season, Preutz, it really has improved.
Now, Roysland, last of the stars to start. Will she be the last to shine? We will see. 1.8 outside, that's fine for Roysland.
Her ski speed's good into the range, only 7.6 behind the best.
Yeah, that's an above average shoot. Average of 2.4 in between each of the shots, and 27.3. She's capable of quicker, but that was just about the right mix of speed and safety. There we go. That's Lotte Lee, as I mentioned earlier on, racing for Belgium. She's gone up into fifth position. Another absolutely fantastic result from her. And she was 15th yesterday, hitting 19 out of 20. It's not going to be Denise Herman's day. Tyrell Eckhoff, she's made life difficult, Mike. You know, that margin of 26 seconds, she's not going to close that down. But top five if she clears.
she will know in the back of her mind that she's not in the race, in the range second time to win, just to contain the result. But even more difficult missing that first stand shot and the last.
Yeah, well, it's a similar start to last season, isn't it? Two poor races, and then suddenly she got into a purple patch that went all the way through to the end of the season. Now let's focus on Hanna Öberg, the local favourite, the star from Pyeongchang for Sweden, has produced a clear shoot, and she's produced an excellent ski time. She goes number one, 19.01, and the fans that have turned out in minus 10, minus 11, minus 12 have been rewarded with an outstanding performance from Hanna Öberg, Olympic champion from 2018.
That's why I love this sport, Patrick. Yesterday, Hanna Öberg finished 74th position. And today, it's quite likely that's a winning time. Although I did say Reusland was my favourite at the start of the day. Reusland still to come in for a stand shoot.
Persson, she was down in the 70s yesterday. Missing six targets. That is much, much better. Good standing shoot from Persson. 33 outside. Now, if she can hold that margin through to the finish, let's see where she comes out. She may be mid-30s. Not bad at all. She's gone ahead of Elvira Öberg. She's got a bit of skiing to do if she wants to stay ahead of the young Öberg sister, who's yet to finish. Elvira Öberg at 37.9 behind, going through 7.1 kilometres. And she's just edged herself ahead of Franziska Preutz. Preutz currently lying in fourth position. Here comes Elvira, started a minute exactly behind her elder sister, and she goes down into fifth place, ahead of Davidova. So Sweden, a much, much better day. So what are you going to put it down to, Mike? The fact that they got difficult conditions yesterday, or the fact that they were just pre-season nerves?
I honestly think pre-season nerves. Their ski speed is so good now, they know they can win, a number of them can win each race. They try too hard, they try to make it work on the range. It didn't work out yesterday, they've controlled it today.
Slightly surprised we've only had four clear shoots so far. Hanna Öberg, and Ace Chevalier Boucher, both of them in the top two positions at the moment. Bendika has gone clear, and Zduic of Austria, she's shot the perfect score as well, and started 27, so she'll be across the line in 4 or 5 minutes or so. Well, there are the standings. Hanna Öberg leads, 19.01.5.
Just looking further back, Patrick, very strangely, Hanna Sola from Belarus, she came in 7 seconds ahead of the fastest so far into the range, but she shot one penalty, and she's only 18 seconds behind, so her ski speed is excellent this morning.
Yeah, Sola, of course, the bronze medalist from Pokljuka in the World Championships last season, finishing behind Ekhoff and Chevalier Boucher. Alimbakova for Belarus, up to the 3.8 kilometre stage. 7.5 Ks, the race distance today. Claire Egan from USA. That's a good standing shoot from her. We'll try and pick up on her position as she exits.
Bendika has great ski speed this year, and delighted to see the Latvian hitting all 10 out of 10. We often said the day she does that, she has a real chance for a top five. Just going to, by the end of the day, it's not going to be a top five. In fact, no, Davidova should beat Bendika's time.
Egan has just gone into the top six for those fans following the North Americans. And that's good. Bendika with 0-0, still nearly a minute outside the best. Lynn Pearson digging very, very deep. She knows exactly what she's got to do. She's gone through into sixth, as you can see, and just ahead of her now is Elvira Urbert. She's going to be pressed to gain another place, but she might just be able to catch Franziska Preuss, who actually had a very good finish.
It's so important having a coach as loud as the Swedish coach on the hill there. You need precise timings. You need to know you've got 2 seconds or 1.6 seconds to catch the next athlete. In this case, it's Urberg. It's unlikely. That's Elvira Urberg.
Yeah, Elvira actually overtook Preuss up to 7.1, Mike, but then lost a couple of seconds to the German on the way down into the stadium.
Here's Reuschland. This looks stable so far.
Yeah, look at the time as well. 14 seconds to play with. She's going to need every single one of them. Top three still possible, but she needs this. She gets the last one. 9 out of 10 for Reuschland. It's starting to look like a season where if you want to win a sprint, Mike, you've got to be perfect on the range.
And that's almost making everyone edgy. I thought Reuschland looked so firm, so mentally there. But, you know, when your heart is beating at 165 beats a minute, a lot of pressure on you. An early season race, and you haven't really got into your rhythms yet. And that's why we're seeing so many shots, just one shot for some of the best missed today.
Herman 11th, having finished on the podium yesterday, so unable to do the double. Just wondering what happened last year. She was second in the first individual, and then she dropped all the way down to low 30s in the sprint. So a similar sort of story, although not quite as bad in the sprint. Now, Reuschland, 14 ahead coming in, 12 behind going out. Chevalier Boucher, I think, needs to be a little bit nervous, Mike, because Reuschland is, well, in fact, 11 seconds down on her time.
Well, Reuschland coming off the penalty loop there. Hannah Urberg went straight out. So fatigue a little in Reuschland's legs. She's got a lot of work to do to try and pull 12.1 seconds back.
Yeah, I think Urberg is safe. Chevalier Boucher tired a little bit on the last lap. She lost what, 10 seconds to Hannah Urberg on that last loop alone of 2.5K.
Alin Bekova, fourth yesterday in the individual. She's good again today.
Lynn Pearson coming in, and that one missed in the pro, keeping her out of the top five. But she goes into sixth for now, just behind Elvira Urberg. So Sweden, Mike, who had a disaster yesterday, no one in the top 10. Currently, they have 3 in the top 6.
Yeah, much improved day. This is excellent for Alin Bekova. She's only, what, some, it'll be 5-6 seconds, a little more actually, from the lead time. 9 seconds.
Hannah Sola, the world champion bronze medalist, skiing very well early on. That's not a bad effort. Third position, despite the fact that she's missed. She is the fastest of those who has missed so far. And she can't quite start the celebrations because Reuschland was only, 3 seconds behind Alin Bekova. Reuschland actually 6 seconds ahead of Sola coming out of that second shoot. Well, there are the intermediate results. Urberg, Chevalier Boucher, Sola from Belarus. That world championship performance was not a flash in the pan. She's done well. Tyrell Ekhoff, Mike, hasn't really started her World Cup winning defense in style.
No, Tyrell Ekhoff, not quite there. A little tense on her skis, Ekhoff, and that's translated into her shooting as well. What a pity for Reuschland, missing the middle shot, I think it was, out of her 5, and cost her dearly.
Now, Reuschland up to the 6.3-kilometer split. She was only 12 behind, now 18. Well, that's a little bit of a relief for Chevalier Boucher, who now has a margin of 10 seconds with only 1,200 meters to go. So I don't think that's going to happen. And Reuschland still with 7 seconds to play over Hannah Sola, who's sitting in third place at the moment. Tandrevold digs deep. missed her opportunity on the standing shoot. 1:28, take away the two penalties. She'd have been closer to, 30 seconds behind, maybe.
Yes, it would have been good. Here's Claire Egan, great shooting, and back in the race today. This is a top 10 performance, maybe even stay in the top 10.
Yeah, the margin 1:15 between 1st and 10th at the moment. She's safely inside that, goes into 8th place. Will certainly go down to 9 when Roysland comes in. And I'm just looking to see, she's in 9th position after the second shoot, so that's looking good.
Well, there's a new foresight. You can see there just slight changes as the years move on to sights and the raising up of the sights. Now they've got wings on the side of the front sights to try and create your levelling.
Well, all it did was tell us that she was way off level.
She certainly was. It was why would you put a level visual when you're always on a cant?
Well, maybe that's to help her be at the same angle every time.
So obviously a good reason in there. Amblikeva, she's not quite got the ski legs to the top of the hill. Little hesitation before this descent. Well, we did wonder if Vera was going to finish outside the top 15. I think she will. She's sitting in 13th at the moment. She's only missed one, and 1 minute 18 behind. Some of that was lost on the range with her bolt, the firing pin and bolt issues. So Reuschland attacking to the line.
Now the time, I think third place is all she can hope for, isn't it, Mike? Chevalier Boucher is going to survive. She left her charge. She's done well over the last kilometre, but she left that charge just a little bit too late. She let a lot of time slip between 6.3 and 7.1. Slightly surprised by that.
Yes, and she'll realise now that Alimbekova is somewhat 5 seconds ahead of her at 6.3 seconds. 6.3 kilometres, I should say. Here she comes.
Alimbekova has done the 300 metres after the range exceptionally fast. And I'm just wondering whether it's a case of pushing the pace too hard, but we'll find out at this split. She's still split. She's still at 15.8, so she's got... it's tight. 0.2 of a second between her and third place at the moment. Hannah Sola, who had third, is already down a fourth, going to be pushed down into fifth. But this is a chance for Alimbekova to squeeze into the top three. It's going to be a very, very fast final corner. Here she goes.
It's not as fast, Patrick. Roysland was dynamic down here. Lots of tucked down low free skating. I don't think that Alimbekova is going to challenge for that third spot.
Yeah, she had 5 seconds over Roysland at 6.3. So I wonder whether that split actually made her relax a little bit. Oh. Roysland is safe. Sola is going down one more position. Alimbekova gets 18th position. It's a really good race, and she'll be delighted with a clear shoot. But the opportunity was there, Mike.
So interesting, the comparisons, Patrick, when you look at the easy part of the track, the cornering and the descents. That's where Alimbekova lost a lot of her time today.
Yeah. And Roysland, I think, got just the right splits at 7.1, wasn't it, when she really started to accelerate.
Well, Mona Brorson, often we see those targets go down. She looked fairly comfortable, but two penalties picked up.
Yeah, she was the best Swedish shot yesterday, the worst Swedish shot today. How strange. So again, just to recap the positions, and they're looking safer and safer. I'm not sure we're going to see a change in the top three. I'm keeping my eye out for a late starter coming through. Puskarčíková started 40, but hasn't managed to challenge, actually dropping down over the last couple of K, down into 10th position. And at the first shoot, Mona Brorson was certainly a threat at that stage. Gasparin, Mike, she's down in 11th after the first shoot. I think she's, has she gone through the second shoot? I don't think so.
Coming in soon, Patrick. She's dropped her ski time a little to 16th place, but if she gets all five, she may contend. Well, this is excellent from Lien as well. Only 13 seconds back at this stage. But it is an early stage.
Vidal, who had an outstanding performance yesterday. I was slightly surprised to see her starting so late, to be honest. Second German in the individual yesterday behind Denise Herrmann, who was in third. That's good shooting.
Well, they do need something to cheer about today. The German team at the finish so far, and a lot of the big German names went early. Denise Herrmann, 18th position. Preutz, of course, in 7th position. So two in the top, in the top 25 even.
Gasparin for Switzerland, unable to capitalize on that good shoot early on. Three penalty loops, 450 meters. You can ill afford that sort of a performance. As we go to Yislava for the Czech Republic. The Czechs at the moment, Puskarčíková is down in 10th position, as we mentioned. Davidova, yesterday's winner, down in 14th, having missed just one. So way, way off the ski speed.
Very interesting day, but and again, if you look back to last season at this time, it was all about Hanna Urberg. The first two sprint races of the season, she won. And she's at the top of the field again today. What a turnaround, 74th position yesterday. And looks like she'll be comfortably on the top of the podium at the end of today.
I was trying to work out who's going to be top of the World Cup table. Roysland has a chance with a 10th and currently sitting in 4th.
Probably
Alin Bekova. I think Alin Bekova might do it. 4th yesterday and currently lying in 4th position here. Roysland, of course, 3rd. I was looking at the 7.1 split.
And Ace Bichon came through with a good 5 there. It certainly cheered Jean-Paul up there on the range on a cold day. He's got plenty to cheer about with a second place as well, and then a sixth place with Brizard Boucher.
Two Belarus athletes in the top five at the moment, Mike. That's good news for them.
And I think when they look back at the tape, as we see the potential winner, I think that they could learn a lot or improve, easily improve with just tucking lower, just trying to get those cornering skills in. And it's unusual at this level to lose so much on Roysland on the descent down into the range. Only 14 seconds deficit into the range, so she's still well and truly in the race, Lien.
Quite a lot of tension in that left eye.
Yes, I remember being told that putting muscular tension through the left eye, it doesn't help your shooting. Certainly not affecting Lien. And it's strange what coaches say, because as long as your right eye can see clearly through that sight, does it matter that you're muscling? I don't think so.
But it certainly doesn't help your ability to relax.
Remember, and Olieina Bjørndalen, the greats, and Halvard Hannevold, later he wore the wraparound, but just gently closing their eye as they come to squeeze the trigger.
That's a respectable start from Chloe Chevalier. I suspect the steeper uphills and the corners on the fast downhills are running just a little bit slower than they were at the start of the day.
I think so. I'm just thinking about the Swedish team, Patrick. They have all lifted their ski speed substantially. And do you know what I think the main ripple effect is? Bring the fastest, one of the fastest cross-country skiers into your team, and it really has lifted all of the biathletes. They know that their place is in peril. If Stina Nielsen can master the rifle, she hasn't yet. So they've all picked their ski speed up, and there's a lot of tension in this team to secure their places for the Olympics, because they know that the relay could deliver gold again.
Stina Nielsen on the start sheet again. Starts number 93, incidentally. Mona Brorsson into 15. And Sweden now with four in the top 15. And that is a massive, massive improvement on yesterday when they didn't have anyone in the top 10. Brorsson was their best, down in 11th. And Elvira Urberg, despite five misses, still managed to come in 18th position.
Well, Leshanka missing two. That's not quite at the same level as the earlier starters for Belarus. I was surprised Retsova wasn't allowed an earlier... Well, maybe she opted for a later start, bib 83. Shot well yesterday, shooting well again today. It's not bad. Yeah, if she gets 10-5 again, Patrick, in the standing, she could threaten the top five.
Well, the margins between first and fourth are pretty slim, to be honest, at 18 seconds. So she's going to have to not only hit the targets, but raise her game. I think a top 10 is probably more realistic, isn't it, Mike? With, what do we got, 52 seconds separating Hanna Urberg in the lead and Puskarčíková of the Czech Republic down in 10th.
Yes, my positive thinking was seeing her clearing five next time in, but no, not quite the ski legs.
Yeah, there's positive and there's unrealistic. Fine line between the two.
Always believe. Oh, such fast, brave shooting.
That's lovely. That is absolutely sensational.
20
Anna
seconds.
Vidal, without a care in the world, just rattles them down. Best shoot of the day. And she came in 35 behind. She should have cut that by a couple of seconds. And if she can keep that margin, she could be heading for a top 10. And Germany need it. Their best at the moment is Franziska Preutz in 7th position. And then we go all the way down to Denise Herrmann down in 19th. The score. 54 down. Take away. What do you think for the penalty loop today, Mike? 26?
I think, yeah, 25, 26. For the women, men, probably 22 seconds in these cold conditions. Lovely stand position there from Yislova. Perfect score, 100% of the targets hit. That's a great feeling.
Well, it's a shame we haven't got a pursuit following this race, because it would be almost like a mass start.
Well, remember last year in this race at the end of March, of course, Vera starting second place in the pursuit, and she came to the fourth shoot, still remaining in second place. Well, almost equal first, just a half a second behind. And then she stayed on the range forever. 2 minutes and 12 seconds. Still missing three. and from 2nd to 26th.
Yeah, these things can happen.
Ah, here's Stina.
Now, what's the ski speed like coming up towards the first split at 2.1? Cross-country to biathlon. Many have done it in the past, and many have done it very, very successfully. Kati Wilhelm for Germany, of course, switched. And Forsberg for Sweden.
And, you know, the coaches, Patrick, as Anna Magnusson comes in for Sweden, the coaches are continuing to put Stina Nielsen, the only Swedish athlete in Group 4. Luckily, today she's at the top of Group 4 with bib 93.
Zidek, she was a cross-country skier before she became a biathlete. The Swedes have a habit of doing that.
Yes, and the great Forsberg, as you mentioned, also. And it paid off. Body's moving a little. You can see the end of the rifle. It's moving. Great discipline.
Yeah, 45 seconds. Compare that to Vidal, who was in and out in 20. So 25 seconds given away on the range. That's a lot of snow that Vidal has covered before Lien is back on track. The targets are down. And suddenly the deficit goes from 20 to 44. Stina Nielsen. She has won some of the Swedish selection races. Well, she hit 5 in the stand yesterday, Mike, so if she hits 9 out of 10 today, Nielsen's not going to be far off the mark.
Well, it's so different. Had she gone straight out on the track, but if you're going to miss early, hopefully she can get 5 out of 5 in the standing. A lot of pressure now on her shoulders. She'll be thinking about it. I need 5 out of 5.
Yeah, you have to respect her decision to switch codes. And I imagine she's faced a lot of criticism in Sweden because she was so successful as a cross-country skier. But she's made a choice, she's stuck with it. And there's no doubt that if she can stay with it for another couple of seasons, then she will be a threat.
I think so. I mean, ideally she wants the Olympic slot or an Olympic slot. That's not going to be easy when the Swedish women are performing so well.
Yeah, and to do that, she's going to need some good results here, either this week or next week. And the sprint really is her chance, isn't it, Mike? The less shooting, the better.
I think so. She's got the speed as well. I'm just trying to see how fast she was on the range. Not quite able to get that information yet.
Vidal just being squeezed out, still at 59 seconds. Now, if she can hold that, she is going to squeeze into the top 10. We've got Bendika at 59.5, Davidova at 59.8. It is desperately, desperately close. But we do know that Hannah Urberg was lightning quick over the last 500 metres. So I suspect we're probably looking at 11th or 12th position for Vidal.
Retsova didn't make it 5 out of 5. She missed 2 there. So no chance of a top 10, top 15 even today.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. Not even going to make the top 12. Bendika on 59 survives. And she squeezes into the top 15. Good shooting, though. Really good shooting. And Vidal yesterday hitting 20 out of 20. So I think she's the only athlete not to have missed the target so far this season.
And she did it in such brilliant style. Rapid fire, 20 seconds. I thought today we might see someone shoot in 22 seconds. Didn't expect 20, and to hit them all is incredible. Just found Stina Nielsen's time on the range and prone shooting. She's 35 seconds, so she's got a lot of work to do. You have to be brave in biathlon, but you need a number of years to be good enough to build your position so fast and release the shots fast. She does need more time to get 10, 9, 8 seconds even off her range times. It takes a lot of repetition.
Yeah, Nielsen in 27th position at the moment, 33 seconds behind. So that's a penalty loop plus 6 or 7 seconds.
Patrick Favre, the Italian, coaching the French team. He'll be surprised at that, I think. All these biathletes without pulse, without being out of breath, easily take 10 out of 10 every time. But then you've got the pressure of making your Olympic team, first World Cup races. Just feels a little different.
Very late start for Amy Baserga.
I think only one of the Swiss made the top 50 yesterday. That was Selina Gasparin. Oh.
I think we'll see a lot more of it. Baserga in the top brackets, top part of the result sheet as the season progresses. She's only 21.
Lien looking for a top 10, and she gets it. She gets it for now. So Norway have number 3 and number 10, and then you have to go down to 25, 26 and 27, which is Tandrevold, Eckhoff and Notten. Roysland, the best of the Norwegians today. Russia, we've hardly mentioned Russia all day. And Nig Matalina is once again the best of the Russians, as she was yesterday.
Yes, she shot well again there today, the perfect score. The wind is very settled now. You could afford actually shooting in lanes 16, so lanes 1 to 15 are prone shooting. You may as well get your recovery and ski all the way up to 16, but they're all opting to stay far left to get some shelter from the buildings, from the wind.
Nice way to finish from Anna Magnusson, and that will give her a chance of certainly going top 15. A minute separating the top 16 at the moment, and it's still Hanna Urberg of Sweden who leads.
So Stina Nielsen building her position. Her time is still excellent. 24 seconds deficit, you can see there as she comes into the range. She's added weight to the end of the rifle. It helped stabilize it, but it hasn't helped the final score today. So one penalty prone shooting, three penalties standing. That's a real shame, a real pity for Stina Nielsen. She wants to be part of this team so much. And now she's got three more times around the penalty loop, 150 meters, setting her back a further minute and more. Jean-Marc Chablot there on the right side. Great biathlete in his time. lives in Sweden with his Swedish wife and coaches the team, assistants to the Swedish coaching team. And boy, the Swedish women today have lifted their game. Three in the top 10. And more importantly, of course, Hanna Öberg, as she did last year, winning the race today. It's not over, but she's not likely to be knocked off that high point on the podium. Reuschland back in form. Third place today. Elvira Öberg, really fast ski time. She's missed two targets and only 38 seconds behind her big sister in eighth place and Lynn Persson in ninth place. Vinklarkova showing us how to get five, no problem at all. Late starter, it's a lonely race back here, fewer people on the range.
Number 95, Christian Kina. One miss on the stand, and Stina Nielsen started number 93. What do you think would be a good result for Nielsen, Mike? What do you think she's got to do to win the confidence of the selectors, the Olympic selectors?
I haven't heard if they have to get, say, three times top 10 position to be considered. Some teams operate that way. I'll find out. But I think the coaches would need to see her consistently making it into the top 15 to then build confidence that, yes, we can take you to the Olympics. When you look at the rest of the team today, they're doing well with three of them in the top 10 and four in the top 20. So it is a difficult team to get into. Stina needs to hit miss only one out of 10 in this race, and she would certainly finish in the top 10.
Kalkenberg, pretty promising yesterday, to be honest. Finished in seventh position. But as you can see, ski speed. Oh, that's a shame. Now, are we going to see a change in the sights? Just a rebuild of the position. And that seems to have done the trick. The last three go down. But no chance of repeating yesterday's success. A PB for her yesterday, hitting 19 out of 20. Best she can hope for today, obviously, is 8 out of 10.
It's a real sinking feeling having to turn left and get this punishment penalty loop, but everyone knows it very well.
Hanna Öberg starting 16, pretty much in the middle of that first group, and totally dialed in today. 19.01, the leading time. Magnussen with one miss. Take that away, and she would only have been, well, she would have been competing for a top five had she hit all of the prone targets. The biathlon if. Or if only.
Such a big if, isn't it? Just looking at the scores, Patrick, I make it 11 who have shot the perfect score today, 10%, just under, 10% of the field. And they are quite easy conditions. I think we can translate that into the men's race. We may see a couple more, maybe 14 or 15 shooting the perfect score in the men's race, if the conditions remain the same.
So Magnussen trying to squeeze herself into the top 17 or 18. She's got Nigmatulina and Yislova just in front of her, fractions of a second. If she's had a good descent into the stadium, it's possible. There is Nigmatulina. No, she's safe. Brussen on 106 is safe. Hauser on 115 is going down another place. So Hauser, who was immaculate yesterday, finished in second place, hitting 19 out of 20. Magnussen betters her performance today and goes into the top 20. Good World Cup points. And take away that miss, she would have been, what, 45 behind? So would have been in the top 10. What a transformation. Sweden have five in the top 20. And by far and away the best nation.
Yes, and surprisingly, Norway, I'm sure at the start of the day, many would have expected at least four Norwegians in the top 10, 20. We've only got two.
Yeah, and Ida Lien is one of those, down in 10th position. Big names like Ekhoff and Tandrevold, a long way down the order, outside the top 25.
I don't think we can read too much into Tyrell Ekhoff. Yes, she was impeccable last year with all her victories, but she takes... She takes a few races getting back into the rhythm, the mindset, being with the team, the pressure as well. I think we'll see her back at the top fairly soon.
Yeah, it's a state of mind more than anything else. But, Mike, she got a win in the second week last year. If that doesn't happen next week, then maybe she'll start to doubt herself. Rita, good start. 4 out of 4, 5 out of 5 to clean the sheets today. And that's a great performance. 53. Let's add another 50%. So she's going to come in roughly a minute and a half down. She might be able to take the scalp of the world champion, Tyrell Ekhoff, who's down in 28th position. Great shooting.
That was it, the only flat part of the course then, up into the hills.
So 1901 will stand. No one's going to better that. And a good victory for Hannah Erberg. Chevalier Boucher once again producing a good sprint result. Roysland relying on her ski speed to get herself up onto the podium, just pipping Alimbekova and Hannah Sola. 15 seconds down. Chevalier Boucher showing us something like the form we saw at the World Championships from her, but Hannah Erberg, Mike, has turned it around. 73rd to first in less than 24 hours. Fantastic.
Another team which will probably be disappointed will be the Italians with Vera, their big hope, 23rd position, and only missing one target. Ziggy Mazé on the right there, just with Patrick Oberegger, Frenchman and an Italian working for the Norwegian team.
No panic yet. By the end of next week, if the results haven't improved, they may be wondering what they were doing all summer, but I think things will come. Sweden will be on a high after yesterday's disappointment. There's the winner, Hannah Erberg. She's had a mixed bag of results here over the years, Mike. She's had World Championship meltdowns, but also World Championship success.
Yes, and impressive today to turn seven targets missed yesterday into the perfect 10 today. Unsettled yesterday, completely in the zone today. And I think we'll see Hannah Erberg, I think we'll see her really challenging all the way through for the overall title this year. And when Elvira, her sister, gets just, she needs to just calm it down. She knows the ski speed has improved so much, and that's exciting. But it's putting her off in terms of shooting, which used to be her incredible strength.
Yeah, I agree. Elvira Erberg, 10 seconds quicker than Hannah Erberg on that first lap.
Yeah, so really psyched up for it. And often that can put you off. Vindisar exhausted there as she's come in. She's only 21-year-old, the Slovenian.
Well, I wonder whether it is going to be Hannah Urberg's season. Certainly, she will have half an eye on the Olympic Games, but she has had success at the Olympics, so I should think that the World Cup overall title is just as important. Well, the men coming up a little bit later on, they're racing over the sprint distance as well, and that starts at 12:20 UK time. Johannes Tingesbo is the man that needs to regain some form after a disappointing race yesterday. Ligrid is the man everyone will be watching.
No, Thank you.
ta frågan. Så är det. Men Mackan sa, eller fan, jag måste äta mer bullar. Är det bullarna?
Jag åt två.
Jag sa till media, men de bara, jaha, vad ska ni göra nu då? För att kopiera Hanna. Jag bjöd hem för bullar igår, så jag kan få äta fler själv.
Ja,
jo,
kanske. Ja,
men
det kan ju bli sådär ibland.
Hur gick det?
Extremt.
Ja, bra liv.
Jo,
nej,
men
alltså, jag har inte gjort det. På banan.
Hanna, congratulations. Great way to put behind what happened yesterday. Actually, can you tell us how did you switch?
Yeah, thank you. I'm really happy today. And before yesterday competition, I was a bit unsure about my physical shape. But I got to see that skiing works well, and it's not a big catastrophe if I'm a bit behind my little sister in skiing. So it meant a lot to me to see that the skiing time was good. And then I know I can shoot. I know I'm a good shooter. So. I wasn't really so upset about the shooting yesterday. So today I just tried to relax and do what I normally do. And of course, yesterday also brought me a bit more extra motivation for a good performance today.
And how does it feel to win in front of the home crowd again?
Yeah, it was so good. I'm so happy that I had the support from the crowd, and I'm really happy that I could bring them some good shooting and also now a win.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Jag var ju såhär bara, alltså jag har inte riktigt tänkt med henne, bara, jag vet inte hur formen är riktigt. Och hon bara, nej det var hon som
hoppade. Ja,
det var sjukt imponerande.
Ja. Belarus.